Well, hello there everybody, and welcome to Tuesday Teaching Tips with me, Sally Cathcart. And resilience. To be resilient is to something that has resilience. It has the capacity to recover quickly from difficulties. And I think we've really shown that as a profession, that we have recovered on the whole really very swiftly from the problems that we've been facing over the last few months. I was just looking for a material, a substance that's resilient, and I found my squishy ball, which I often use if kids are pressing on too hard, you know, playing with what from. And that, of course, is resilient because it springs back into shape. Now, yes, okay, it might have a few dents, and yes, it's getting a bit grubby now. And yes, it's probably something I'm not going to use in the future because of the surface. However, it is a resilient material. It bounces back. And as I say, I think that's just what we've done as a profession. However, we're going to have to continue to be resilient, and we're going to have to continue to be innovative and to think differently about what it is we do and what we offer, and indeed whether teaching the piano actually is the only thing that we can do. So right now, there's all sorts of questions going on. Do we do face-to-face? Do we stay online? And we now know we have the ability to do both. Some advantages, some disadvantages in both areas, I think. But actually, in a way, that's the easy thing, what we're doing now. Because there are tough times ahead. There really are. A lot of people out there are going to be losing jobs. You hear on our news in the UK from the BBC, almost on a daily basis, about tens of thousands of jobs, possibly people being made redundant from their jobs. And that will impact on our teaching and on our teaching studio. And I think it's inevitable that we will all lose some students. So the question is, how do you bounce back from that? How do you future-proof your piano studio? How do you future-proof yourself? What other skills do you have? What else can you bring? What else can you offer as a service to people that might not be exactly what you want to do, but actually would help tide you over in this difficult period? And now's the time to think about this. Now is the time to think about the next 5 years. Yes, I'll say that again. Now's the time to think about the next 5 years and how you see that developing and what steps you can take. So being resilient is absolutely crucial, and thinking ahead will really put you ahead of everybody else out there. We're doing a lot of thinking about this in June in the community, because our whole curiosity box this month is all about this building a resilient piano studio. And of course, our offer of a free month of membership is still available to anybody who wants to pop in and join us for that month, and then you can leave absolutely no charge at all. If you want to continue, then our monthly subscription kicks in. But I would urge you, though, to really consider this very seriously about how resilient your studio is, what you can do to actually make it a future-proof studio for the future. So I do hope you are keeping well wherever you are in the world, and I do hope that the sun is shining in your heart, if not in the weather. And do take care. I'm just going to see who's been watching today and say hello. I can see Jane is there. Hi, Jane. And I can see Janet is there. Sinead. Hi, Sinead. Lovely to see you here as well. So take care, everybody, and see you again soon. Remember, be resilient. Build that resilient studio for the future. Bye-bye.